It's the Normies Cozy 4. We're back at you with more BoJack Season 2, Episode 7, Hank After Dark.
What does that even mean?
I think we're going to meet somebody named Hank, during the PM hours.
Knife After Dark? Is that what it's a...
Knife After Dark?
Yeah, isn't that a thing? Excuse me while I Google. What was the last thing we saw, even?
BoJack knowing Drew Barrymore.
There was one we watched.
I feel like right now BoJack is going through this like really high, like with that owl girl, you know, and he's enjoying it, and he's like, you know, it's hard for him to say I love you and all that. This is all new to him, you know what I mean? And he's just really, really enjoying it.
I just love
as being in the Secretariat and being in a relationship, but BoJack being BoJack, I feel like history's going to repeat himself, and things are just going to go haywire eventually pretty soon.
Yeah.
There's nothing ever... One thing I've noticed is, in Hollywood, nothing good ever lasts, you know what I mean? I feel like it's definitely what's going to happen here, you know?
I will jog your guy's memory real quick. It was the autoerotic asphyxia.
I love you.
His BoJack's co-star is dead.
Damn, he did the gasping goo.
He did the gasping goo. He did the funky Spider-Man.
Are you funky Spider-Man, Nikki?
He did the choke off. The choke off kit. This is my choke off.
step by step instruction. Like everything he would ever need to like do it. That was funny.
I know they were like giving tips in that episode. He's like, well, you could use an iPhone charging cord, a belt, really anything, a garden hose. Like,
but that's true.
I know. It's
Wanda funny. And BoJack had a nice little moment. She said,
They finally admitted, I love you to each other. So they're at the L word now.
Whoa. 1994.
Whoa.
I'm Scott Wolf.
And I'm Matthew Fox.
Matthew Fox.
But the fox is the wolf and the wolf is the fox.
That's Jack from Lost.
Hank Hippopopolis! Hank After Dark!
This is the same guy who Dancing with the Stars who's like, when I think they can't dance, I tell them.
That is?
Yeah.
Do I know you?
This is my better half, Katrina Peanut Butter. Katrina?
Oh, this is his first wife.
Can I get a picture with you?
Of course, kid.
Here, let me advance this. And
we probably got it.
And we'll find out in 4 to 6 weeks.
Don't beat yourself up too bad.
How many flasks does he have just here on the ground?
This suit needs more flasks.
This is gonna be interesting.
I gotta learn who composed this because I know they passed, but it's such a dope beat.
Here comes one part.
It's also when the butt goes by, so it's your part. Ba ba da ba da ba 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 da.
If you haven't cringed
yet.
Y'all weird. Diane! Will you bring me one of those big Toblerone?
Dude, Toblerone bars are shit.
Oh, I want to go to the gas station to get one right now.
I won't be out there for another month.
Yes, I know, but I always...
Oh, she's on her way now.
You're a movie star now. Any bad press you get can hurt Secretariat.
Now boarding flight 422 to Juneau.
Please, we're going to Alaska. How am I going to offend a bunch of inbred Eskimo blubber munchers?
Oh, God. Like that.
By the way, Eskimo is an offensive term. I never knew that.
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
Someone commented on one of our videos.
I mean, not why, but like, wow. Why?
I had no idea. For people native there.
When I was a kid, this guy was the guy. I even bought his novelty rap album, The Hank Hippopopolis Hip Hop Hippopolis.
You want me to go get you some chili?
Good call. Chili is nature's chillaxative.
Chillaxative.
I love me a good bowl of chili. Yeah, me and Mickey can slam some chili, bro.
Chili's delicious. I need to throw
some
away.
Serge can make some good chili.
Some Steak and Shake chili.
Thank you.
Yeah, Steak and Shake chili got that gluten.
Hank and Mr. Peanut Butter are back to back. Thursday.
Back to back.
Guys like us, we're pros.
Guys like us? You think I'm a guy like us? Oh, this is the happiest moment of my life. Excuse me, would you get a picture of us?
Yeah.
This guy. Mr. Peanut Butter,
he's
bro.
A mess. He's a so worm. Funny. There's a worm.
Do you think Israel has a right to defend herself? And what part should the U.S. play as
oh,
an ally?
Oh, no.
Oh.
Well, the thing about that, I
Palestine and Israel.
From the table in 2000. I mean, obviously there's no panacea, but a two-state solution with an emphasis on human rights feels like a place to begin.
Oh. Oh. That's like the best. Wow.
What?
He like nailed that.
Like both right there with their hats.
There are plenty of other celebrities who have done much worse things, and it hasn't hurt their careers.
Like who?
I don't know, like Mike Tyson or Sean Penn or Josh Brolin or Josh Christian Brolin. Slater, Woody Allen, Hank Hippopotamus.
Man, no, I like Woody Allen.
Hank Hippopotamus.
What about Hank Hippopotamus?
Oh no. Diane's gonna fuck up.
Same allegations.
I feel like we're getting off track here.
Do you really not know about that?
Any other questions about me, the handsome famous horse with the book?
What do you have against Uncle Hanky?
I'm not saying anything that isn't already on the public record.
Oh, she's gonna fuck it up.
Oh no.
You don't have to Google it right now. I'm
dug up from nowhere, you know
yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah,
just because
yeah,
a bunch of people Googled it.
Prince Gustav went missing briefly this afternoon, but he was quickly found buying chili in Beverly Hills.
What?
That was like Todd. That was like Todd.
That is Todd.
What's going on here?
He's on his random adventure.
I think, did he switch spots with Todd?
Nah, bro, that is Todd.
We're gonna see that eventually, maybe.
Against our beloved hippopotamus. Joining me now is Hippopopolis Apologist.
Hippopolis Apologist.
Cardigan, Burt Cardigan.
These allegations are so crazy, I can't even say them on TV, person or I'll sound like a opinions. Crazy person. What I want to know is why we're letting a national treasure face the same kind of smear tactics used by the Viet Cong.
Are you calling attention to the fact that Miss Nguyen is Vietnamese?
I'd like to think that's a coincidence.
Oh, what?
There's a giant replica of my head, and every episode, the eyes light up with dollar signs, confetti shoots out of the ears, then I somersault out the mouth. We're bringing class back to primetime. Some website called Tit Puncher is saying you said some stuff about
Oh my god, Mr. Peanut Butter, I didn't mean for that to happen.
Hey, do me a favor. Please don't make a big thing out of this. It's really not a good time, you know?
Oh, for him, yeah.
Wow, I didn't even see Mr. Peanut Butter care about him first.
Tit Puncher,
I love you too.
I mean, yeah, it is his job, you know.
What do you ask for? I am peasant boy Todd from village. Friend of Peanut Man and lover of Federer.
Yeah, he switched spots with Todd!
He does look different.
That's not Todd, that's the prince!
Something different. I am digging this new cologne. You smell like a fancy cabbage.
It is so great to be in me.
Todd has stubble too, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Look, I'm telling you, man, it's the prince!
He has a mole.
He's like clean shaven and he has a mole.
Hey, look at me, normals.
No.
If Hank did anything wrong, they wouldn't let him on TV, right?
I'm really not here to talk about that.
You women are all the same.
Excuse me?
Yeah, you make these broad accusations to get attention for yourself, and when you don't have proof to back it up,
is
you
that?
Just slink away.
I'm not slinking away.
I just wanted to say one thing about me. I text and drive, like, all the time.
What?
Why does that grandma look so familiar to me?
They ruined his life?
Diane, you should probably just drop this.
Oh, I'm gonna drop it, all right.
Oh,
they don't
no.
even know how much I'm gonna drop it.
The way you said that kind of made it sound like you're not gonna drop it.
How dare you, predator!
Oh.
Way to drop it, girl.
I know.
I gotta say, I'm opposed to child labor, like, as a rule, but there are some kinds of labor that children are just better at. You ever try to fit into a mine shaft? That is a tight squeeze.
Oh my god.
Oh, that's fucking hilarious.
Oh man, probably gonna get some letters about that, huh?
Yeah.
I'm so incorrigible. Everyone's paying attention to me now.
Oh, he's trying to take the heat off. Okay.
Anyone else want a snack? No? That's a no? On the snacks?
He's trying to, like, it's just like, this is the hot button issue right now. Fuck anything else. Like, even if it's, like, what he's saying is real.
We don't know what happened.
At least find the mandatory body cams for great time.
Oh, I'm not even reading those.
You write novels on the...
We don't know the facts.
They say...
You're supposed to
to be a journalist, and you won't even tell your audience what he's been accused of.
Well, you're such an expert. Why don't you tell us?
Yeah, tell us. Say it.
Measles.
It's supposed to be my book tour, and she's completely upstaging me. Kind of like how it was supposed to be my book. Actually, this might just be a thing she does.
She knows that the only thing keeping my network afloat, right? The same network that employs her husband? Why would she do this?
Sometimes she just whips herself into a frenzy, and she loses all perspective. God damn it, Honeydew! Jesus, why does Cantaloupe think every time he gets invited to a party, he can bring along his dumb friend Honeydew?
Dude, I'm with you on this, bro. I completely fuck Honeydew.
I agree. That's a running joke from the previous episode.
That's a running joke from the episode where they made the bi-monthly curated movie.
Curated snacks.
Got those.
Hammerhead shark.
You know it's a federal crime to go through someone else's mail?
I do not know your customs, for I am dirt. Poor servant child.
No, don't worry about it.
Now what man?
I love the way they're telling this top
story.
Yeah,
like, what happened?
I love the way they're telling this.
How, what happened?
His wife, she poke bear, yes?
Yeah, I guess she kind of did.
They have a saying where I am from. Which is here.
I can always count on you to give me the straight dope. Please don't ever change.
Diane, I want you to meet Amanda Hannity, editor-in-chief here at Manity Fair.
Oh, no.
Manity Fair?
I sense an alliteration coming.
Manity Fair.
They're going to do a long set alliteration again.
Okay, I wanted to pitch you an expose on Hank Hippopopolis.
I would love to take down Hippopopolis and finally topple the acropolis of monstrous hypocrisy that ensconces us.
There it is.
When we know what we know about a monster like that, and we still put him on TV every week, we're teaching a generation of young boys and girls that a man's reputation is more important than the lives of the women he's ruined.
Yes, exactly.
Well, you know I've got your back, right? We women have got to stick to... Hey, fruit plate!
No!
me!
Everyone is gunning for you now because you're a woman who's talking out of turn about a man. We're not supposed to have opinions. We're just supposed to smile and look pretty. No, this model doesn't look as pretty as the other one. Can we kill it?
Wow.
Hi, my name's Nicole. I work for Mr. Hippopopolis, and I really need to talk to someone.
Are you kidding me with this Honeydew right now?
What's wrong with Honeydew, you fucking haters?
Honeydew is shitty.
It's so yummy.
Shitty ass.
You are shitty.
That is great.
Shitty ass person.
Honeydew sucks.
Nicole.
I'm never gonna understand this.
Uh oh.
Thank you.
This is Hank After Dark.
A deal? The regular deal?
His royal fortune to charity.
Oh no.
And fired his chief advisor, who can be seen in this file photo looking vaguely suspicious.
Oh, you idiot, no!
Reforms which could lead to sweeping change in the embattled region or a precipitous economic collapse. What is Diane's
problem? I fucking love that.
He's like leading a revolution.
I don't get it. How?
I bet he's gonna like change it for the better.
Oh, I love Todd.
I'm sorry.
How did he end up there? Please let there be an episode that tells that story. Like, just that story.
People love me, and they're not gonna forgive you for this.
This isn't about me.
If you keep pushing this, you're gonna drag down the people close to you.
Oh, no.
She is. That's how Hollywood works. Hollywood.
Go home to your husband.
I know who you are.
Sweetheart, everyone knows who I am. I'm Hank Hippopopolis. Who the hell are you?
Ain't that some truth?
Back in the 90s.
I'm not giving up. There's gotta be someone who will talk.
Oh, listen. I had a conversation with my bosses at AOL, Time Warner, PepsiCo, Viacom, Halliburton, Skynet.
Skynet. Toyota, Trader Joe's.
Statue of Kitty.
So this has nothing to do with the fact that AOL, Time Warner, PepsiCo, Viacom, Halliburton, Skynet, Toyota, Trader Joe's also owns MBN and is currently profiting off of Hank Hippopopolis' good reputation?
I know you're upset. Would you like a JoJo? It's just like an Oreo, but Trader Joe's style.
No, I don't want a JoJo. Okay. Because
dude, this is so, like...
This is good.
So,
This is Mr. Peanut Butter Show, right?
Yeah.
It's gonna get canceled.
He's gonna jump out of his own mouth.
But Diane's gonna... I don't think he's gonna make it to the first episode.
We don't torture people in America, Todd. That's called one of the amendments.
No, of course. In America, you do not know to suffer. You eat your cheesy pizza, you drink your aid of Gator.
Oh, life is nice for Gatorade.
Peace, but no way for live. I go now back to palace.
He's bald.
So they hated the Skorts idea, huh?
No, I didn't pitch your Skorts idea.
Hey, Diane, why don't you shut your stupid face?
Hey, don't you talk to her like that.
Yeah, don't listen to that guy, Diane. I said,
local honey, distant honey.
This is not what people here
want. What is your end game in all of this?
You don't actually believe Hank's innocent, do you?
Of course not, but that doesn't matter. You're not going to beat this guy.
Was
that Todd?
BoJack, thank God you found me. I thought I would never see you again.
We're kind of in the middle of something.
Oh, he still has his Latin Kings tattoo.
From jail.
This is the first time we've seen him without his hat.
Have you heard about it on the news?
No. Most of the news has been about Diane and Hank.
This is really funny. Like, it shows like how Hollywood news overtakes like real life news.
This
is so on it, dude. People, y'all need to watch this shit.
This is banging on all cylinders right now.
I don't understand why you can't be on my side about this.
I am on your side, and I am telling you, you're not gonna win this thing. Also, P.S., when have you ever been on my side?
I am always on your side.
Really? Like when you wrote that book?
Burn.
You manipulated me and completely took advantage of—
Guys, there is a very fragile alliance between the Kords and the Ovians. If we don't do something,
Todd,
nobody cares, Todd.
You got everything you wanted because of that book. You were a joke. Now people take you seriously. You were out of work?
Is she losing her shit again?
I mean, she's right, kind of.
That's true, but she, like, losing it again.
And you hurt my feelings. And it's weird that you never apologize for that. Mm. And that you still won't.
I'm sorry I hurt your feelings.
That's so me, I'll never do.
Actually, I probably could have handled things better. I definitely should have. I'm sorry.
Okay.
But this is bigger than you and me, and I need you in my corner now because I don't have anybody else.
Good thing his career too.
Oh, she made instead of side.
Yeah, like
she's gonna get everything canceled.
Earlier,
Mr. Peanut Butter.
Some general asked me if there was
but
a
she's
call
on a good fight.
On that
though.
Talks about
but
I said yes, and he said
he works for AOL Time Warner, Skynet, Toyota. Literally,
no,
you know,
I'm not
real
sure
life.
That was the right.
They could have thrown Disney in there.
Well, I called Wayne to see if I could write a story for BuzzFeed, and here's the good news. They'll publish anything.
Hey,
you're BuzzFeed.
I asked you really nicely not to make a big thing out of this.
Yeah, I know, but someone
had to say something, right? And that someone had to be you? What is accomplished by you being the one to take a stand on this? This game show is a really big deal for me. And I know that sounds stupid to you, but I need this to go well. And I can't... Those are death threats. People want to murder my wife.
Oh my God, I never thought this would happen. He's doing this.
You can't. You stupid, ugly can't.
Yeah, that doesn't say can't.
Oh.
You'd almost be safer in Cordovia.
Yeah, maybe I should go to Cordovia. I'm obviously not making a difference here.
Actually, maybe you should. Go feel good about yourself.
Huh? What?
Work. And maybe some space might be good for us.
Finally, he's eating with his head. Mr. Peanut Butter, you're such a smart... God damn, you're not a dumb dog.
Why does it suddenly matter what I want?
Mm-hmm. Exactly. She fucked it up for him. I bet he's not even gonna be able to jump backwards out of his own mouth now.
Oh my God, she's leaving?
Yeah, with Toblerone.
Did you do it?
No, I did not.
Well, that's good enough for me. Coming up, Kanye West claims to hate Thin Mints. Our panel is outraged.
Hating Thin Mints?
Thin Mints are
is
awesome.
He legally insane?
You can bet we'll get into this further in the next hour. This is the only thing I care about.
Like Thin Mints.
I think chocolate mints are stupid.
They're fucking
disgusting.
Delicious.
They're disgusting.
What?
Mints are so delicious, bro. Chocolate and mints are not
Found
supposed
it.
To mix.
Just
like
it.
Chocolate, orange, chocolate, and cherries are not supposed to mix.
What's wrong with you?
Chocolate.
Okay, we have a lot to talk about. Pause.
That was good.
That was a good episode. I'm gonna let the music play out. Sometimes it's
just
a nice
movie. I like that episode a lot.
Who would have thought? What, Mr. Peanut?
What overall theme?
There's a lot to say about that one.
Yeah. That was a bit. Man, it's a juicy ass show. Yeah. Bro.
One overall theme that I'm going to say that I definitely saw in this episode that is true to like real life is that Hollywood's bullshit drama overtakes the real news that is out every day. So it's cool. So fucking crazy, man. Like, literally, there will be massacres, genocides, and the worst shit on the planet. And then the next thing you'll see, next to that huge-ass article, that's not so important.
Kanye West hates Thin Mints. We'll get into this in the next hour.
Some shit like that. Like, it makes no goddamn sense, man. This like, what the fuck? Like, it happened
Don't
recently.
This is America.
It happened recently. With, like, fucking, like, Kanye West, like, making all your goddamn tweets. Shit. Like, about
Trump or
whatever the fuck. It, like, took over the news while, like, so much other shit was happening. It's fucking sad.
You guys.
Man, I feel like that shit is planned sometimes, but that's a whole nother topic. Go on.
This was an extremely layered episode.
Feeling episode.
Layered episode, so I'm sure we'll get into all of it, but I'll just say my spiel.
Yeah.
And it has more to do with Diane and Mr. Peanut Butter. And in the beginning of the episode, they kept bringing up the, like in the flashback, we saw him with his wife, and he was like, marriage, it lasts forever, like we're in the good parts of our lives. And now she's going to Cordovia. He obviously asked her, like, we need space. And like you said.
Oh, he's Cordovia?
Yeah,
she's going.
The same place where Todd was?
Yeah.
I didn't even think about that. Link the two together. That's the same.
Yeah, she's going to Sebastian. But.
Okay, go on. Sorry, I didn't know it was the same one.
No, but what I was going to say...
You didn't know the whole
Yay, time. Serge doesn't know something for Yay. Once. Yay.
Earlier you said they say so much without saying a lot, and like, you know, earlier in the beginning of the episode, he was like, buy me a Toblerone, bring me a Toblerone. And then we saw her with that giant Toblerone. Yeah, it's a nice gesture or whatever, but going back to what Mr. Peanut Butter said, it's like, you're going out there to be with a rich bachelor, you know, billionaire, what should I have to worry about? And she's already making that, like, you know, I don't know, the Toblerone says something, you know what
so
I mean?
Guys,
like, she's bringing him the Toblerone, so yeah. I think when she goes there, I think it's gonna fall apart, dude.
Obviously.
I think it's gonna fall apart.
It's already falling apart. Did we all know, at least I didn't know, did we all know Mr. Peanut Butter was married before?
Yeah, he said something about having
he's
a bunch of
he's been married, like, three times. Yeah, he's gone to, like, three different divorces.
Did you know that?
I kind of forgot about
it. Okay, thank God.
He mentioned it offhand.
It was said very quickly.
Okay,
y'all had a reaction to it. It was genuine. They just forgot. You know,
I think
been a while.
I forgot
we watch a lot
that.
TV.
I'm sorry.
You
I know, think that might have skipped
you,
my mind.
You guys did catch it when it happened, but it was said.
Okay, so right now it actually skipped my mind. My bad on that. But for me, this whole season at least, I didn't realize Mr. Peanut Butter was married. So I thought, he's not really Diane. He's a good dog. You know, good dogs are loyal, blah, 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 blah. But the fact he's like, hey, Diane, I think you should go do your thing makes me feel like, yo, he's the attaching now. Like, yeah.
Yeah, like he's breaking his code. Like,
he's not that loyal.
Loyal canine code. But
yeah.
He did ask her one thing very nicely. She literally took it as far as it could have possibly went. And I don't know if there's any ramifications for his show. It's, to me, like, didn't he describe, like, oh, there's a big mock, like, my face, and I'm going to jump backwards out of my mouth. I feel like that stuff is going to be gone now, maybe. Or
Why?
I don't know if there's any repercussions, because it was his wife that was doing all that.
He just got the death notes, though.
Well, yeah. I mean, it's already out there, but, like, the thing is, like, he did ask her, but it's, like, it's a hard situation. It's a complex situation because you can't really get mad at Diane because, like, she is fighting a good fight. She's trying to bring out darkness into
but
the light.
But it's what BoJack said. Anytime someone does that, and it's sad, and this is the dark message of the show right here, mm-hmm. That guy works for AOL, Time Warner, Skynet, Toyota, blah, 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 Disney, whatever the fuck you want to call it. That's real. There's,
yeah.
Like, three commodities in the whole world, Viacom,
but,
that own
but,
everything.
But,
please don't strike us.
What's his
please
name?
Don't.
Just
You own us.
But what's his name that's been getting away with it for, like, what was it, Winkler? Right?
It's kind of like Harvey Weinstein.
No, Weinstein.
Weinstein.
He's finally going to jail. So, like,
yeah,
so,
because a bunch of women came
I know, out. He's been getting away with it for years. And,
years!
And it's terrible the
so
things he's
read
done.
So, you the stories, right?
But, like, okay,
it's crazy.
But getting back to the point, and let me finish my point. Like, Diane is fighting the good fight, but Peanut Butter had a good point. He's like, why you? Why do you have to be the one? It's almost like Diane gets a kick out of being in she gets a kick out of being the savior. Like, yeah. She wants to
be
different.
She has a complex.
But
this was definitely
Diana. Hold on. Let me finish my point. She wants to be the savior, but someone has to be. Someone has to be. So you can't really get mad at Diane here. But at the same time, it is like, Diane, do you have to be the one? But someone has to be.
Before your point, I just have a quick thing. Isn't it great? You would never have thought when you first saw the first season that you would be enjoying Diane and Mr. Peanut Butter's relationship so much, because you never would have thought you'd care about these characters, but their relationship is a very, like, central focus on the show as well. Because they're like... Because
it started off so typical.
You can relate any relationship to them.
Like, okay. It started off so typical, it would have been like, okay, BoJack gets with her by the end.
I'm going to go out on a limb, and, like, you know, the whole entire thing where Mr. Peanut Butter at the end was like, Diane, like, why were you there? Why'd you be the one? Like, in some cases, man, she had to be the one, fam.
That's what I'm saying.
AOL, Time Warner, Disney, blah, blah, blah.
She had to be.
Someone has to
be. If it wasn't her,
I'm fucking sick of this shit.
Nothing happened. She changed nothing.
But
not
maybe,
yet.
Maybe
not
she will.
Yet.
But that's what I'm saying.
That's
like,
what I'm saying.
Like, Weinstein, obviously...
We're all repeating each other.
I'm sure Weinstein has had allegations against him throughout the years. But
yeah.
It's finally catching
the,
up
the
with
age
him.
Of this
so,
episode kind of showed, because this was not out before all these allegations came forward. This is, like, a few years old, because... Even the little old lady was like, oh, you're a woman trying to go against a man. Are you kidding me? That shit is actually being taken. That's the reverse thing.
If anything, this just goes to show how, like, social media and the voice, our voice is fucking prominent. You know what I mean?
I
and we need to keep fighting with that shit, fam.
And it
and
was
for free internet.
It was
Thank
also
you.
A very powerful scene where the chick at Manity Fair... She was almost like, she was a strong, independent woman, and she's like, no, we're just supposed to be the women, and we're supposed to smile. Like, she was saying it defiantly. She was like, we're just supposed to be the women, we're just supposed to smile, we're supposed to be the set piece. And then right after she said that, she was like, oh, this model's not pretty enough, let's cut that. Like, it was like immediate hypocrisy, you know, like, it was... Man, this was a
good
episode.
It was good. This was really
okay.
Good.
Besides,
of course, she went back on her word.
Can I
be real?
I feel like this season is really getting into what the show's trying to do.
It's pulling out everything.
And it's really fucking good at it, dude. I fucking love it for right now. I'm not gonna lie, the first season I didn't feel that much, but this I'm liking it. It's
but
good.
You had to go through that. You had to kind of see it. Like,
kind of like techno music.
Don't you relate to them in some way? I know we're not stars, pseudo YouTube celebrities. But, like, going through the same thing, like, BoJack always worries he's going to be, like, you know, mediocre for the rest of his life. Or, like, Diane getting hate mail. Mr. Peanut Butter, like, doesn't want to read hate comments about his wife.
Oh, yeah.
It's just like...
Oh, yeah, dude.
We deal with it.
We kind of understand a little bit more so, but it sort of does a great job of painting this picture for everybody, so...
It does.
Yeah, dude.
No, it does.
A-plus episode. I like
Todd.
Besides the whole Diane BoJack story... What did you guys think about cantaloupes?
Fuck cantaloupes.
Cantaloupes?
Sounds great. Honeydew sucks.
Cantaloupes?
Honeydew? Or
honeydew. Fuck honeydew.
I was eating cantaloupes.
Cantaloupes are great. And as with Todd, man, I'm not gonna lie to man, Todd's a shit, bro.
Cordovia.
I'm just gonna say, I just feel
what
like...
What happened there?
I love all the shit that he gets into.
I had no idea it was the same place.
That's fucking hilarious.
Yeah,
I put two and two together. It made it so much more funnier for me, because I like, when he was saying genocide and shit, I was like, this is fucking
He's like, nobody cares about that.
And then when they were like,
you
when
guys explained to me
when they were like,
what really happened, though?
Then,
I feel like I lost at one point.
And then when they were all like...
We don't really even know.
When they were all
okay,
like...
Good.
Sorry,
when they were all sitting there and they were all like, Cordovia, all the Cordovia's riches have been given to charity, and they're talking about prosperous new changes. I'm like, yes,
or economic collapse.
Like, yes, fuck yes, Todd.
Yeah, I almost thought like Todd was inadvertently like helping the country, but it could go either way. Obviously he's back at the embassy, he's back in the States, so he's not there.
And you know what else was a tongue in cheek reference to all this, like, was the Israel Palestine thing. Like, that there was this is the issue.
BoJack's handling it.
Like, also, like, other things surrounding that area.
BoJack.
Cordovia
is just, like, their mouthpiece of, like,
that's the parallel.
Where shit is going down.
BoJack is great at that shit.
And Diane, of course, wants to be in
And
center.
It's still very extremely relevant because of the embassy thing that recently happened. Like, Trump opened the embassy in
Israel.
Yeah, and the
and in the same day, those 70 people fucking
protesters died.
Yeah, I know that. I hope you guys all read that.
Yeah.
However, Todd did what he did.
It's very relevant.
It just goes to show that the real good-hearted person in this show, I feel like, is Todd.
Yeah! Dude, I'm gonna make a Todd. I'm gonna make a Todd totem. I'm gonna be Todd for Halloween. I'm gonna be Todd for Halloween.
Todd is just, he's full of potential.
Hey, this was a very horsing around. You're lying, you drank something. This was a very horsing around, you know, episode.
That's zero.
Fuck yeah, that's not a point. He's mad because he didn't get one on our last Avatar episode. Okay, I wonder.
You wonder what is going to happen next?
Yeah, I got that one.
I wonder what's going to happen next.
I did that one right at my feet. You guys have to give me that one.
Tell you what, I'm down for another episode, and I got a real hankering for a piss and a beer.
I'll tell you what, Diane's acting like a real nut, but her enthusiasm is impeccable. Nut butter.
I'll give you...
Dick butter.
No, I don't know.
Okay, fine. That doesn't work. Guys.
Why are you Bojacking, bro?
What the fuck was that? Whoa.
Whenever I came up with my joke.
I don't know, man. Who knows what is real anymore?
It's real. He did it. You're the only one now.
Yeah.
You're the only one. Now you're Serge. Remember Serge from Korra last week?
Hey, whoa. From now on, the last person to pun has to turn off all the stuff.
Yep.
What?
Yeah. Hey,
I want Todd to not do that shit.
I already used that.
I want Todd.
What does that mean?
I want Todd.
It's called a terrible pun, and you're not a man of your word because you lost.
I used my pun.
Bye.
Hey, don't get offended by that.
Such a crazy fucking poor thing. I'm just saying.
Hey, turn it off, Mickey. Are we done?
For this one?
Thanks for joining us for another BoJack Horseman. Big shout out to everyone for keeping this channel going, especially our super patrons. Luis, Bear in the Garage, Joe, Keyboard Junkie, Toy Soldier, NYR Fan, Robert D, Benjamin F, Cool Cat, and Joey S. Check out our Patreon for uncut and early access content, and we will see you next week.